I must be careful now. About that, my friend. Survey the area, Sunan. What do you see?
Where is my Salakar?
Take it easy, it's right here, nice and safe. I wanted to investigate something, but then I tripped and...
Can you walk? No. Oh, then I shall carry you.
Oh, gentle! I ain't a bleeding sack of spuds, you know.
What have you learned of the Salakar?
Might just know how to use it. Of course, you're going after Surtur.
Show me.
Have I got your ear? Might just know how to use it. Of course, you going after Surtur, you'll most likely end up feasting in Valhalla.
Valhalla? It is for the feeble and the blundering. No, I shall not die. Worlds may end, but I, Harvey, shall abide.
What about Sindri? You calling him feeble?
What would he be doing in... Ah, yes. Yes. He is there in Valhalla, of course. For one such as he, it is a great honor. Now then, this looks like a good place to put you down. So, tell me the Salakar's purpose.
Having a clue?
Can it kill Surtur?
Well, that ain't its purpose. But yeah, I think it can.
How?
It harnesses the light. A lot of light.
That was Baldur's gift. To turn day to night and back. Is that why Surtur stole his hooker?
Yeah, the others. They're just for balance. But, see, there is one more in there. Like Baldur's. Incomplete.
Whose is this hooker?
Surtur's. An itsy bitsy snippet, mind you.
I don't understand.
I think if the Salakar touches Surtur, the two will come together.
The Salakar's already complete. Nothing gets in or out.
A torn Hooger will always try to reunite itself. His might just be strong enough to do it. If that happens, he will become the Salakar.
Then nothing can stop him.
Only if he can control all that light. But I don't think he can. His old carcass ain't made for it. It'll be like trying to hold the ocean in a single hog's bladder.
This thinking. How can I be sure you're right?
You ain't heard all me workings out.
Do you truly believe the coming together will be too much for Sutra?
Best try it when he's weak. Ideally dead. Not dead, of course. Just normal dead. Before he wakes up all over again.
You've done well. Now give me the Salakar and leave this place. It is too dangerous.
I ain't leaving. I come this far.
Do as you're told, friend. I wonder, does Broker send me to my death? No, my destiny is Ragnarok, far in the future. Not Svartalfheim. Have a look, Zunin.
One shall dare strike down the seed of Odin and live to tell the tale.
Here, fool. Your twilight comes.
Still drawing breath? I have a cure for that. Oh,
busy choking on your own sword.
Truly, dear friend, I worry about your future.
Here, fool. Your twilight comes.
Still drawing breath? I have a cure for that. Unwell! I ripped out his neck.
You won't squeal. You're busy choking on your own sword.
I fear a dark destiny awaits you. I will be master of all nine realms.
But I even master of the two. This is no place for dwarves. I've earned my right to see this through. I told you it would work, and there you are, doubting me. I might have got it wrong. Looks like it was just a key. That, on the other hand...
Half a key. You want the rest? Come, claim it!
You really shouldn't have come here.
You! Come and claim it! I don't run from the fire! I am the fire!
Time!
There is no escape!
Die!
right
for your grand plan, you fool. You sought to harness the power of the light. The power of my son! It would have turned you into the wrecker of worlds. But in this feeble state, his light will devour you whole!
Three! Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You'll get us whipped, or worse.
Leave us be.
What are you doing here?
Be on your way.
Please, brother, I see.
I'm pretty soon.
You But I'm prettier. Don't go telling the other shelters about all the food and drink we got here.
You're looking for the blacksmith? He's out. Went on an expedition, he said.
Did you hear about how Harvey is in the
Oh, that's
Please,
terrible.
Don't be seen.
But I heard that.
Oh, she's really
late.
We've enough misery.
What are you doing here? I'll be with you shortly.
Huh?
Show me what lies ahead. Sunan, guide me.
Over here.
It's Kara, isn't it?
So you do remember.
Why wouldn't I remember my own Valkyries?
It has been many ages since Odin, son of Bor, father of Thor, took his duties seriously. Instead, he frets about the future, tries to wriggle free of fate. That's what I hear.
Mind your words, girl.
Whatever you say, my lord and master.
Now, let's discuss your duties. This field of battle, does it bear fruit?
The harvest proves underwhelming. Many have died, but without valor. Unlike real heroes, they flaunt their wounds on their backsides, not their chests.
What use will there be to me when Ragnarok finally comes?
You have nothing to fear. I will make them ready for that final battle.
Perhaps I can help.
How?
Why, let my own battle prowess serve to inspire them.
You intend to tell them your old war stories? Not even we Valkyries believe in those fantasies anymore.
Then draw up an arena, so that I, Harvey, Lord of Asgard, patron to all true heroes, may reenact my finest moments. Just the way they happened.
This should be fun, if nothing else. So be it, lofty one, your arena awaits.
Remind me what I'm doing here.
In this arena, you can spin your tall tales and fight your old foes, so as to help the Einherjar prepare for the great battle of Ragnarok. And, of course, for my own personal amusement.
Let me tell you a story.
Let's see what embellishments you add to this one. I am looking forward to this. I will bear witness to your deeds in battle.
Listen now to the tale of my first meeting with the Lord of Muspelheim.
Dies by the enemy's hand, not his own. Show me the blood, the chaos, the screams.
Listen now to the tale of my first meeting with the Lord of Muspelheim. I made my way onward. I saw Muspels lurking ahead of me. I attacked in a battle fury. Soon enough, I chanced upon a fearsome Muspel, glowing with inner fire.
I'll have burnt throw for my...
Fire on him! Finish that!
glorious battle indeed, I think you'll agree.
To relive such legendary battles pleases me greatly. Let us hear your tale of glory.
Once I did battle with one who had betrayed me. Listen close, and I will tell you how it went.
Yeah!
mine, as it ever shall be.
Over here.
Let me see what rewards I am fighting for here.
A boon to any warrior's arsenal. You can't afford it anyhow. Farewell, Lord of Asgard.
Let me tell you a story.
Let's see what embellishments you add to this one. I am looking forward to this. I will bear witness to your deeds in battle.
Listen now to the tale of my first meeting with the Lord of Muspelheim.
You are brave to proceed thus.
As I made my way onward, I saw Muspels lurking ahead of me. I attacked in a battle fury. Soon enough, I chanced upon a fearsome Muspel, glowing with inner fire.
You look cold, Harvey. Let me warm you up. Blustering fool! You seek to thwart fate?
Glorious battle indeed, I think you'll agree.
The Skalds will sing this story through the ages.
Let me tell you a story.
Let's see what embellishments you add to this one. I am looking forward to this. Let us hear your tale of glory.
Allow me to recount one of my glorious battles with my cunning brother Loki.
Odin dances like a gadfly, stunning the prey. How heroic.
Ahead of me. I saw what I knew to be my prey, and I struck. my tale concludes in glory and honor.
Well done, Harvey. Stirring tale. Show me the blood, the chaos, the screams.
Here is the true tale of how I defeated two of the Muspel's greatest fighters. The blood from my weapon. A group of Muspels took me by surprise.
Thor lends me strength.
Fate steered me into the path of a mighty Muspel, and battle was joined. Valkyrie. I have more where that came from.
The Skalds will sing this story through the ages. Anyone? Over here.
Let me see what rewards I am fighting for here.
Ah, the battle glory that has seen. You can't afford it anyhow. Farewell, Lord of Asgard.
Thank you.
The wolf is coming, brothers and sisters. It finds us all in the end, no matter how we hide. In its jaws is an end or a beginning, and we will never know which till that last black bite. Should we lay down for it then? Bare our throats to its teeth, or fight with every sinew in our bodies to hold it away, knowing always that our strength must fail, and the wolf will take us. I know only this. Each day is a gift from the dead to the living, each smile bought by another's tears. And when the wolf runs free, all we will have are those we fought to keep. So I will keep you, my people. I will fight the wolf for every inch of this land till the hour he claims me. I will buy you your days of love and laughter. Use them well. These new visions of Odin trouble me. Am I alone in seeing them? Or do the tales of Svartalfheim hold some other meaning? Perhaps I should warm my bones by the fire. Gather my thoughts for a moment. Oh, look at you, Tui. Tove, how have you been?
The fire made me think of the myths and legends Sven loved.
Would you indulge me with a tale? I would be glad to hear of Svartalfheim.
I would not tell it half as well. But his favorite was a fable, to remind us to find meaning in our deeds and not in how others think of us. Svartalfheim was not short of legendary dwarven blacksmiths. Everyone has heard of Ivaldi, of Brokkr, and Sindri. But this tale is of a stonemason. He lived as far south as he could, where Gulnamar meets Vangrim. His workshop sat upon the shoreline. Obsessed with glory, his love of masonry had all but died. He scoured the shore, seeking precious stones washed up from other realms. Then he saw it. Something beautiful, glittering, shimmering across the water, upon an island he had never dared travel to. He hastily built a boat, working long into the night. He set sail and found many rocks that sparkled and dazzled upon the island. He cried out in joy. To craft anything from such stones, he would be remembered for all time. Then he felt a sudden sting on his foot. Then another, and another. His eyes adjusted to the dark. So consumed was he by his desire for renown, he failed to realize he had walked into a nest of snakes, until it was already too late. And so, clutching the stone that sealed his fate, there he died. Remembered, yes, but only for his folly.
A fine tale, Toby, and well told. Sven would be proud. Story, there's truth to be found. I wonder what could be found in Svartalfheim, the place they spoke of. Aid me, be my eyes. Careful, grandmother. Something fell from the sky to earth, like it had been thrown by Odin himself.
A strength he no doubt wishes he possessed. No danger remains, but look. It revealed something hidden in the mountainside.
Looks almost like a door.
If it is, then it's the door to something that I have long been searching for. May I ask you for a kindness, Drengur?
My name is Eivor of the Raven Clan, and that depends on how kind you need me to be.
Will you grant me a home while I investigate the door, Eivor of the Raven Clan?
I don't make a habit of sheltering strangers.
My name is Hildoran. There. Now we are no longer strangers. Please, if I am right, then this is Freya's gate. Allow me to stay, and I will help you discover the treasures that lay on the other side.
Very well. I will give you a small piece of land to make a home on, and supplies from our raids to build with.
Thank you, kind Eivor. The gods smile on you.
I may be kind, but I am no fool. Everyone must pull their weight, and I expect no less from you.
A fair rule, and one I can easily follow. Eivor the Kind. A welcomed visit. Like what you see.
You've certainly made this space your own. But how does this help you open a stone door?
It is a shrine to Freya. We will need her favor if we wish to reveal the hidden treasures.
Ah, it's we now, is it?
I told you, Eivor. You will want to see what is on the other side. Now come. Freya demands combat before she will aid us.
For a moment, I thought you meant for me to fight you.
Fear not. I can handle myself.
I cannot possibly fight you. I would kill you.
You could try. Attack me. Now get up, and let's give Lady Freya a fight. Fight harder, Eivor. Yes, give me everything you have. You're leaving yourself open to attack. You're leaving yourself open to attack. Good. Now watch. Come at me again!
What magic is this? And how do you fight with the strength of a berserker?
I can teach you, Eivor. But first, we fight!
These are not my weapons.
Are you already making excuses, drinker?
I have seen many strange things, but nothing like this. What magic do you possess? I have not seen a seer fight like that.
I am no seer. I am what you see before you. An old warrior with a knowledge of secrets.
If that was not magic, then what was it?
That was a battle meditation. You entered Hugerheim, the Mind's realm. It is a secret form of training that not many know. You can attack full force with no fear of injury.
And yet, you know this training.
You're glad to have let me stay now, aren't you?
Very much. Tell me, what part does the amulet play?
It is a vessel. It needs to be filled with the energy created in battle. But it will only work with this type of shrine. They can be found all over Mercia.
I have many questions still.
I promise you will get answers. But first, I have marked a shrine location on your map. Once there, enter a meditation. The amulet will pull you into Hugerheim.
And what happens when I've finished my training?
Then you return to me.
Very well. Have you met Valka? Something of you reminds me of her.
Go now, kind Eivor, and train.
Been eating fish? Thank you.
Thank you. Ha!